Samuel Richardson's Pamela or Virtue Rewarded. Synopsis. Pamela or Virtue Rewarded is the title of an epistolary novel, رواية رسائلية, يعني رواية عبارة عن a series of letters, written by Samuel Richardson, the English writer, and published in 1740. The letters are written by Pamela, the protagonist, and addressed to her poor parents, the Andrews. The novel is based on a story about a servant in the name of Pamela Andrews, and the man who, failing to seduce her, marries her, or her master, who tries many times to make an illegal love relationship with her, but because of her continual rejection and her virtue, he finally submits and proposes to her. Pamela Andrews is a 15-year-old servant in Bedfordshire estate. Bedfordshire is the location or the place in which Pamela works as a servant. On the death of her mistress, her mistress' son, Mr. B, begins his frequent attempts to seduce her. The girl refuses his inappropriate advances or his very bold and impudent steps towards her, to force her into this illegal relationship. The girl tries to avoid him by fleeing and locking herself in her bedroom. She suffers from an internal conflict or inner conflict inside herself between her strong religious training and her desire for the approval of her employer. Here, the writer Samuel Richardson is rather realistic in his approach to draw the character of Pamela. As a human being, she starts to feel mutual love for her master, but she rejects expressing her love and accepting the illegal relationship because she was a religious girl who has to hold fast to her virtue. She confides in her best friend and housekeeper of the state, Mrs. Jervis, which means she tells Mrs. Jervis about this secret. Later, Mr. B hides in Pamela's clothes and tries to kiss her when she undresses for bed, causing Pamela to consider leaving her position and returning to her parents to preserve her innocence. She is insistent on remaining at the state to finish embroidering a waistcoat for Mr. B, hoping that by doing so he will let her leave on good terms. Here, Pamela again suffers from an internal conflict. She rejects and becomes annoyed with Mr. B's advances towards her, but at the same time she wants to keep her salary for her poor parents. That's why she wants to leave the house of Mr. B without making any further problems by giving him a waistcoat before leaving. Angry at Pamela for telling Mrs. Jervis of his attempted seductions, Mr. B informs Pamela that he intends to marry her off to Mr. Williams. This is the reaction of the master, Mr. B, as soon as he realizes that Pamela has told the secret of his relationship with her to the housekeeper, Mrs. Jervis, and he decides to get rid of Pamela by marrying her to a man of religion called Mr. Williams. He's a chaplain in Lincolnshire, and gives money to her parents to persuade them to give consent or agreement. Mr. B gives Pamela's parents some money in order to accept this marriage proposal between Pamela and Mr. Williams. Pamela refuses the engagement and decides to leave the state, but Mr. B intercepts her letters to her parents and tells them she is having an affair with a poor clergyman. The reaction of Mr. B is that he stops Pamela from sending more letters to her parents, and he wrote letters to the Andrews telling them that Pamela is having an illegal relationship with a poor man of religion, and that he will send her to a safe place to preserve her chastity out of fear or worry about her safety. He will send her to a remote place in order to preserve her honor or her innocence. Pamela is forcibly or by force taken to Mr. B's Lincolnshire estate by Mr. B's servant, Monsieur Colbrand, where she begins a journal or writing her daily diary with the intention of sending it to her parents. The Lincolnshire housekeeper, Mrs. Jukes, is odious and unwomanly, which means she is a kind of strange, manly woman, devoted to Mr. B and keeps Pamela as her bedfellow. Mr. B promises he won't approach Pamela without her leave or without her consent or without her agreement, and stays away from the state for some time. As Pamela is mistreated by Mrs. Jekwes, she begins communicating with Mr. Williams, the poor man of religion, by letters, which they leave for one another in the gardens. After Mrs. Jekwes beats Pamela or strikes Pamela after she calls her Jezebel, Mr. Williams entreats the village gently or goes to ask the noblemen or the rich people of the village for help. Though they pity Pamela, the rich people in this village have pity towards Pamela. They are too loyal to Mr. B at the same time and are convinced or persuaded or believe in that seduction would either not occur or not happen or be inconsequential or without any harm due to Pamela's low social standing. And here the hypocrisy of the rich people is apparent. They believe that because Pamela is a poor girl, so her honor or her virginity is not important at all. Mr. Williams, or the poor man of religion, proposes marriage to Pamela to help her escape the state and Mr. B's advances, but shortly after is attacked and beaten by robbers or thieves. Pamela attempts to flee or to escape or run away home to her parents, the Andrews, but is terrified by two cows she mistakes for bulls. Mr. Williams accidentally reveals his correspondence or letters with Pamela to Mrs. Jacques, the housekeeper, and so Mr. B has him arrested, announcing that he will marry Pamela to one of his servants. Desperate, Pamela attempts unsuccessfully to escape by climbing a wall and injured gives up, or she leaves this idea because she cut herself. Mr. B returns and offers Pamela a list of conditions, مجموعة من الشروط he would meet should she accept him his hand in marriage. He is ready to do these terms or these things if she accepts him as a husband, but she refuses, citing her reluctance to think above her social station to become his mistress. So that she thinks he might take her as a mistress, not a wife. In league or by the help or consent with Mrs. Jacques, Mr. B molests Pamela or tries to approach her body while she is in bed dressed as the housemaid Nan. Pamela is sent into hysteria and seems likely to die. Mr. B repents and is kinder in his seductions, but Pamela implores him, توسلت إليه, to stop altogether. Mr. B implies he loves Pamela but will not marry her due to her social status, because she is a lower class person. Pamela has hidden parcel of letters or hidden group of letters to her parents in the garden, but they are seized or caught by Mrs. Jacques, who gives them to Mr. B. He sympathizes with Pamela on reading her account or her narrative of their relationship and once again proposes. Pamela, still doubtful of his intention, which means she is not sure if he is telling lies on her as he wants her as a mistress or as a wife. She begs him to let her return to her family. Though vexed or though angry, he does so to her surprise. on leaving for home, Pamela is strangely sad, and on her way home, he sends her an apologetic letter a letter of apology that prompts her to realize that she is in fact in love. When she hears that he is ill, Mr. B is ill, she returns to him. The two reunite and become engaged, and Pamela explains that she rejects Mr. B's advances because she feared he would attempt to take advantage of her without marrying her. Mr. Williams is released from prison, and the neighboring gentry or rich people come to the estate and admire Pamela. Pamela's father, Mr. Andrew, arrives at the estate, fearing that she accepted Mr. B's proposal by force. Or unwillingly, but is reassured when he sees her happy. He feels comfort when he sees his daughter happy. Pamela and Mr. B wed or get married. When Mr. B leaves to attend to a sick man, his sister Lady Davers arrives at the estate and threatens Pamela, calling her marriage a shame. Pamela escapes by the window and is taken by Colbert to Mr. B. The following day, Lady Davers, the sister of Mr. B, enters their bedroom without permission, revealing that Mr. B previously seduced a girl called Sally Godfrey and had a child with her. Pamela reconciles the furious siblings or brother and sister. They return to Bedfordshire. Pamela rewards her friends and servants with money and forgives her father for attempting to end her engagement. They visit a farmhouse where they meet Mr. B's daughter and learn that her mother now lives married in Jamaica in the Caribbean islands. Pamela proposes taking the girl home with them. The neighborhood gentry, who once despised or hated Pamela, now praise her or admire her. Pamela tries winning over those who had disapproved of the misalliance or mismatch or this bad marriage because it's a cross-class marriage between a man from the upper class and a woman from the lower class. Actually, this novel caused much controversy upon its release. Critics disapprove this novel for its bad representation of men as a hunter for women. Also, it's a kind of porno novels for its many physical scenes. Also, they objected the fact that Samuel Richardson makes this marriage between a poor girl and a happy man, a rich man, a kind of reward for her virtue. Critics believed that virtue should be based on principles, and belief in the necessity to do right thing, not to wait for the reward. And if there isn't any rewards, so you stop becoming virtuous. This is the end of this lecture. Thanks for watching and goodbye.